welcome back to the sideboard one last time here at the StarCityGames.com Modern Open in Dallas, part of the SCG Tour, brought to you by Twitch and Ultimate Guard. I'm Nick Miller alongside our now Open champion, Peter Hollman. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Handshake, a little bit of hardware to go along with it. Another trophy going back to Louisiana. It's been happening a lot lately.
Yeah.
Now, we got to talk a couple of things, because obviously Dredge was the name of the game this weekend.
Right.
It was everywhere. We saw it on camera, a bunch of copies in the top 8 and the top 16, all that kind of stuff. I did not expect a Death Shadow deck to show up and be the thing that kept it in check. Was this something you had kind of planned all along? Did you know you had a pretty good matchup with Dredge?
And I'd like to say that it's something I planned, but the reality is I only really feel comfortable in three decks in Modern. Blue-white base control, Shadow, and Grishelbrand, which is an awful deck. Don't play that deck.
Okay.
And I didn't think blue-white was good, so I was like, I'll bring Shadow. It's what I'm most comfortable with. That I think is good in the meta. I actually, my 15th card in my sideboard, I debated between the second Liliana and a Bajuka Bog, and clearly should have chosen Bajuka Bog, but you know.
Well, you took down Dredge a handful of times, not only in the semifinals and the finals that we saw, but also earlier in the Swiss today, so clearly you were doing something right. You know, we saw it back in the day, Shadow is still fast enough that you can just pressure these decks and win, and that was definitely the case for you. What was the considerations going with the four-color build versus something else?
So I think KCI is a very strong deck right now, despite the fact it didn't really show up too much. I think against Tron, having Stubborn Denial, because I'm really just Jund / Stubborn Denial, is incredibly important, because outside of exactly Wyrmcoil Engine, their turn three plays are stubbornable, and also like so is Ugin, which is, you just never beat Ugin if it resolves. So. I felt like the Stubborn was worth it, and it's not like you're really losing life you don't want to lose anyway, so the splash is basically free.
Right, something interesting you said in your profile was that your opponent's Creeping Chills were actually pretty good for you all weekend.
Yes.
I think if people are building Dredge this way, Shadow is actually a, you know, decent choice. Your Shadows are getting out of control, and then you just get to win.
Yeah, I agree. It's scary, because sometimes you have to put yourself down 2-6. Or, you know, 6 or below, and they have like a chance to mill like double Creeping Chill or something like that. But, you know, the math on that's good for you. It's just like, go for it. I think the Trample is the big thing that helped me so much versus Dredge, though. The six copies of Trample, 4 Traverse, 1 Gore Clan, 1 Teamer Battle Rage. And their goal is to just like stall you with chump blockers, and they can't do that if you have Tramp.
Definitely. And then the other card, Guilds Rattling, has showed up.
Yeah.
You know, your opponent and you both had it in the finals, Assassin's Trophy. We didn't see a ton of it throughout the day and throughout the weekend. But how was it for you this weekend?
It was the best thing Assassin's Trophy did for me was freed up sideboard slots. Two of the biggest problems are Tron and then also, Worship specifically. And so I had used to have to run Maelstrom Pulse in that, and then that was, whenever I get
you
to remove Maelstrom
Pulse. If you want, it's no big deal.
I'm sorry, yeah.
Live TV here.
Yeah, of course.
People are very excited about you winning.
Yeah,
so it freed up a bunch of sideboard slots and gave you some more options.
Yeah, basically I no longer have to run Pulse, and it like can kind of help somewhat with Tron hate. I don't like Assassin's Trophy and like black-green against Tron. You're still going to lose that matchup most of the time, but since I have a fast clock, I think the Assassin's Trophy is actually decently valuable.
All right, any closing shout-outs or anything? I know you came down with Tannen, another trophy going home in his car that doesn't belong to him, but you got to be pretty happy.
Yeah, shout-outs to everyone back home who's been rooting me on. Shout-outs to everyone who came with me. We had a blast. Shout-outs to all Louisiana Magic. We're the best Magic state per capita in the U.S.
The shots have been called.
Yeah.
Everyone's on alert.
Yeah.
I'm sure Tom Ross, wherever he is, you know, Seattle, pretty happy with that claim. Congratulations.
Right, thank you.
Good job this weekend. We're going to send it back over to Patrick and Cedric one last time here in Dallas.
Congratulations.